Hi, my name is Phi Pham. So today I'm going to talk to you guys about the first nano CVD furnace. This furnace is used for synthesis of materials such as graphene and carbon nanotubes. But we can also use this furnace for processing such as vacuum annealing. I'm going to talk about the general layout of the tool today and specifically how to safely operate the tool. And I really want to highlight specific hazards associated with the tool in addition to safety mechanisms built into the tool to help us operate it safely. We're going to want to sign in on the clean room computer. To do so, we can just go to the computer here and sign in with your username and password. In addition to signing in, we also want to fill out the logbook. Every time you use the furnace, you want to fill out the logbook for information such as the gas cylinder pressure. So the EasyTube 3000 is split into three main parts. The first part is the computer control. This allows us to do real-time monitoring of the conditions within the furnace, in addition to programming our growth recipes and conditions. If we move down, we will go to the loading chamber, which is used to load and unload our samples. And finally, behind this panel is the furnace itself. Now, usually during operation, this panel will stay closed for safety, but today, let's take a look inside to see what the furnace actually looks like inside. Now that we have the panel door open, we can see that the furnace consists of a 5-inch quartz tube surrounded by an insulating clamshell. During operation, the clamshell will close and allows the quartz tube to be heated up to 1000 degrees C. On this side, we see the injector ports in which the gases are introduced into the quartz tube. Our gases will flow through the tube towards the dry scroll pump. The layout of this furnace allows us to not only control the flow rates of the gases being introduced, but also the base pressure within the quartz tube. One final thing, as a safety mechanism, there is a built-in gas detector above the furnace. This will tell us if we have any gases leaking from the quartz tube. Because chemical vapor deposition usually includes hazardous gases at elevated temperatures, a number of dangerous situations can arise from improper use. We can immediately identify the furnace as a high temperature and a high voltage risk, but because of the use of combustible gases, we also have the risk of combustion. If ever the gas alarm goes off, or if there's ever a foul or pungent smell detected, we can always push the emergency off button, and this will safely shut off the CVD furnace. So the main hazard associated with CVD is the ignition of a combustible gas. In order for a combustible gas to ignite, three conditions need to be satisfied. The first condition is that we need an energy source for ignition. Second, we need to have combustible gases in between the lower explosive limit and the higher explosive limit. And finally, we need the presence of oxygen. Now, if we think about inside the tube, we have two of the conditions already satisfied, energy source and the presence of a combustible gas. Outside of the tube, we know that we have a energy source and the presence of oxygen. So the main key is to separate oxygen and combustible gases. The easiest way to do this is by doing a leak back check. By doing a leak back check before every growth, we can ensure that oxygen does not go into the quartz tube and combustible gases do not leak out of the tube. Now that I have discussed the main hazards associated with the tool, let's discuss how to actually operate the tool. When we get here, we want to make sure that no one is using the tool. And so we want to check that the loading chamber is unloaded, and we can also verify that by checking the load lock control panel. Right now, we can see that the green light for unloaded is on. This means the tool is in standby and ready for us to use. In order to start a recipe, we need to go to the computer first. We begin by opening up the CVD Win PRC program. From here, we're going to select our desired growth recipe. Today, I'm going to pick a graphene growth recipe. And then we're going to click OK to make sure to save our data logs. Once we do that, The graphical user interface will open up, which allows us to monitor the temperature, flow rates, and pressure of the CVD furnace in real time. In order for a recipe to begin, we need to make sure that the burn box, or CDO, is powered on. The burn box is responsible for burning up any surplus gases that we exhaust out. To verify that the burn box is powered on, we want to check that the temperature is set to 800 degrees and that the power is set to 90 degrees. The recipe will not start unless the burn box has reached at least 700 degrees C. Once we verify all the values of the burn box are correct, we can go into the service chase to make sure that the water cooler and the gas cylinders are turned on. So we're standing outside of 2349, which is the service chase for the EasyTube 3000. We need to go in there to verify that the gas cylinders are turned on and that the water chiller is turned on. But before we enter, we need to make sure that there's no spills outside the service chase door and that there's no pungent smells coming from the service chase. If you ever see one of those situations, you should contact staff immediately. Today, it looks like there's no spills and there's no smells coming from the service chase. So I'm going to enter the service chase now to verify that the gas cylinders are on and the water chiller is on. Now that we're in the service chase, the first thing we want to check is that the water cooler is running. We can see that the water cooler is on and it reads 19 degrees C. So the water cooler portion of this is ready to go. The second step is that we want to check that all necessary gas cylinders are ready to go. To do this, we can see that the in-use cards are turned, and we can also check the pressure regulator to see that the gases are pressurized. Today, we're going to be using argon in addition to hydrogen and methane. Hydrogen and methane are stored in this special hood, and once again, we can verify that these are turned on and ready to go. The final aspect to make sure that the CVD furnace is ready to use is to check this box here. This tells us that a green light says that the exhaust is working correctly and that we are ready to run our recipe. Now that we have verified that the gas cylinders are turned on and that the water chiller is turned on and that we previously checked that the burn box is turned on, we can begin our recipe. What we want to note first also is that the nitrogen is flowing and that's purging our system, but no other lines are flowing gas right now. And that's what we want when we load our samples. So we'll go over to the loading chamber. What we can do is we can open this door and we can pull out our quartz boat. This quartz boat is what we're going to load our samples on. All samples must fit on the width of the quartz boat. So now that we have loaded our samples onto the quartz boat, and we make sure that it's no greater than the width of the quartz boat, we can put the boat back onto the loading arm. We want to do this very gently, not to put any pressure on that loading arm. We'll fit it into its grooves, let it sit, and now we can close the loading chamber door. From here, we're ready to load our samples into the furnace, and this is an automated process. To do so, we'll go to the load lock control, and we'll click load end cap, which will begin evacuating the loading chamber to ensure that no hazardous gases goes into the furnace. So when I click that button, it's going to start pumping down on the loading chamber. We can hear that the pump is working. So what we want to do is we're going to hold this door a little bit to help with pumping down. Then we want to verify that the pressure begins to drop on the pressure gauge. So what we can see is that the pressure gauge shows that the pressure is dropping. Once it reaches 5 times 10 to the minus 2 torr, it's going to backfill the loading chamber with an inert gas, and then the loading arm will automatically load into the furnace. So now that the chamber has just pumped back up to atmosphere with inert gas, What you can see is that the loading arm automatically starts to begin moving to load your sample into the furnace. So now that our sample is loaded, we can see that the arm is no longer in the loading chamber and is in the growth chamber. We can verify that over on the load lock control. We can see in the load lock control that the green light for loaded is on, which means now we can start our recipe. Since our burn box is powered on, that means we can go to the reset button. Once I hit that reset button, it's going to run the recipe. Every time you hit that reset button, it's going to sound an alarm to indicate that the recipe is starting, and what you need to do is silence it and reset it. So I'll go ahead and do that now. I'm gonna hit the reset button on the top toolbar. This is gonna start our recipe. Silence the alarm down and reset it, pushing it up. And now you can see that there's no more alarms lights on. So after you hit reset to begin the recipe, every recipe has a leak back check stage. This series of pumping down ensures that there's no leaks in our system. And this is a safety mechanism to ensure that no oxygen gets inside of our tube and no combustible gases leaves the tube. After the pump down stage is over, the recipe will begin and the furnace will begin heating up. Okay, now the growth chamber is back to atmospheric pressure, and we can see that the ready to transfer light is solid green. That means we can go ahead and on the load lock control hit unload end cap, and this will remove the loading arm back to the loading chamber. So now that the loading arm is unloaded, it's no longer in the growth chamber, it's back into the loading chamber. What we can do is we can remove our samples. Usually, if you do this right after growth, the quartz boat is gonna stay really hot, so be careful when you remove it. So to do so, we're gonna open up the loading chamber again and gently remove the quartz boat from the loading arm, placing it down. We can close the chamber, and now we can remove our samples again. When you remove your samples, you can put the quartz boat back onto the loading arm, close the door, and your process is now complete.